Hi, this is Ironheart, and I'm about to bring you another Spaceship House video. Hopefully we'll remember to put the link to my first Spaceship House. The first Spaceship House was a Royal Piglet, then I built a custom Spaceship House, and now I am on my second Spaceship House. The first Spaceship House that I actually built was a trading vessel, and you can actually Google trading vessels, and merchant vessels, I'm sorry, and it'll explain the merchant vessels. Merchant vessels basically were ships designed to take cargo, but they were normally armed to ward off pirates. Now, I've got a new level 50, and on this character, since he is a military type character, I built a rocket vessel for him. And the history of rocket vessels date back to like the 1800s. A matter of fact, one of the the most famous of the rocket vessels that I know of was the HMS Erebus, I believe is how it's pronounced. It's E-R-E-B-U-S. And that fought in the Battle of Baltimore in 1814. Now, these early rocket vessels fired what was called Congreve rockets, C-O-N-G-R-E-V-E. And Congreve rockets of the time was extremely inaccurate, and they were designed more to frighten the enemy rather than to actually kill the enemy. Okay, now this ship is far from finished. I decided to go ahead and do a video of it so you can see actually the unfinished product. I got everything laid out where it should be. Now, this ship, the backstory of this ship is that it was a old Olsen warship that was purchased and it's being retrofitted for the Grinnock. Now, the good thing about the Olsen is they were very big and they were very tall, so it's not like trying to fit a Grinnock in a human vessel. And that's one of the things I found. My first Spaceship House was actually built for humans by my human avatar, and this guy is very huge in it. I tried to do a video with this guy in the other ship and found that he was taking up so much space it was hard to actually be able to do a camera angle in it. Excuse me one moment. Oh yeah. Okay, having a bit of a dry throat there. Okay, so this ship, now the first ship I did cost me somewhere in the between 250 platinum. This ship right here, I don't think I really have a platinum into this one yet. Maybe at the most a platinum and a half, two platinum. Actually, I do have a platinum in it because the doors, the spaceship doors, is 50 gold each. Okay, so probably less than 5 platinum versus about 250 or more platinum for the other one. Mostly, this ship is comprised of drops and stuff that I bought from the housing vendor, with the exception of the spaceship engines. My wife gave me one, and I don't know where she got it. And the other ones I had bought back when I bought the other ship. Someone sold like 5, 6, or 7 of these. I'm thinking they probably meant to just sell one, but they didn't split the stack, and I ended up with a bunch of them. So I ended up with a bunch of spaceship engines, and so I just kind of, the ones I didn't use, I put over here. Now, this ship is going to have retractable landing gear, and it's a missile ship, so it's going to be equipped with mostly missiles. I'm probably going to put a couple of cannons on it, but it's going to be mostly missiles. And here where you see these round vents here, I'm going to put in these, which is going to simulate some kind of anti-gravity system. So it's going to have a number of those under it. Right now, I believe I have somewhere in the neighborhood of 60 missiles on this ship. It has a intimidating presence, very heavily armored. So this vessel would come down and support ground troops. It would actually put troops on the ground. And as you can see, the bottom hull plating on this thing, under the command section of it, is an entire one story thick. I mean, you're not going to really penetrate this armor with anything they got in Wildstar. The land I'll showcase later. What I'm doing is, this is going to be kind of like an excavation site. I'm going to probably stick like a little small military base on it. Most of the stuff that I got on here dropped in Octera. The skull, the plating that I'm using on this, mostly dropped in Octera. This was a globe that I was going to make and put in. I'm not sure if I'm going to actually use that or not now. These two bots here were drops in for the Keeping Them Down quest daily and the Defile. And this guy right here, he doesn't do anything. You can highlight him all day long. But this guy does. And I'll see if I can show you something my wife discovered. Now, if you ever did Keeping Them Down, you know you could kick these guys' heads into the shield and it explodes. But here, it'll actually knock this bot right here down. It doesn't do any damage. You stand in it, I think it'll knock you down. Let me find out. Okay. So I'm going to go here and I'm going to stand, oops, if it'll let me. I'm going to stand in the red zone here, see what happens. Wow. And I land on my feet. Okay, so that was pretty cool. Now, I haven't got the back door in yet. I haven't actually done the bottom part, but this is where the troops will actually deploy. And of course, you're going to need a door between the outside of the ship and the bridge. Alright, so, where am I going to start? Let's start in the bridge. Okay, this ship is designed to feel cramped, and it's a warship. It's not comfortable like my other ship. There's no big open spaces, but there's not endless hallways either. Everything leads to something. So first, we have here the bridge. And I have my, the captain's seat is here. Captain's seat is here. Now, there's a little glitch that happens. Let me see if I can get past that glitch. Sometime if you just interact with it, there you go. Now it'll work. So I used a Soul Frost or Soul Forge throne, right? Sometimes I get a little tongue-tied. And I put a leather seat in it so he can actually sit in it, because you can't actually sit in this one. You have to actually put a chair in it or under it. But from the captain's perspective, he's got a monitor. He can see the main view screen. Over here, this is the intel station here. They can do communication surveillance. They got maps. Spy on the Dominion. I mean, that's just your general intel station. Here is going to be a conference area where they're going to be doing the battle plans. Here's your ship controls. You got there's a lot of redundancy in this ship, so you can gather intelligence from several different locations. And if one location is destroyed, you can still pilot the ship. It still will maintain the ship's functions. So throughout this ship, there will be quite a bit of redundancy. So if you have, because this is actually, the ship can serve as a command ship. And if systems start to go down while you're under attack, you will have additional systems. But we all know what redundancy is, so. Here's the pilot's seat. I'm still working on this area right here. But this is where the pilot would actually have a very nice view. You got, the only reason he got this side windows over here is so he can see out both sides right here when he's landing the ship, because the ship is actually made to land on a planet. There's no actual living quarters on this one, because this is one that just takes troops into battle. It supports ground troops, and it gives the commander some place to actually conduct the battle while being protected. But the captain actually does live on the ship, and this is the captain's quarters right here behind the bridge. It's small, it's cramped. I haven't furnished it yet. My wife's an architect. Now, I've got a master architect on my other avatar, but my wife just started architecture, so I'm letting her actually get everything furnished up here. And it's also kind of fun working with my wife on a project like this. So she's going to make the a lot of the stuff that's going to go inside the ship. So where does some of this stuff come from? Okay, these round doors right here. You see them in the auction house. But they actually come from Palaver Point. They're 50 gold each that you buy from the vendor. And I don't mind if somebody charges like a platinum or a platinum and a half for them, but they've only paid 50 gold for it, so that's cool. This is the Dominion screen, by the way. And just like the Exile screen, you can actually, I think there's 5 different screens you can change to. It was a drop, and I can't remember where it dropped. Same with this one. I think some dropped in Octera, but I believe the rest may have dropped either in Starcom Basin or while killing a world boss. But if you don't know what the Exile and Dominion screens, they actually, when you see them in the auction house, when you do the preview on them, the screen is blank. I'm trying to get to that. This is what it looks like. But once you buy it and put it in place, or if it's a drop, you now can cycle through several different screens. This is a Soul Frost monitor. You get this in Octera from the vendor, and you pay for it with Soul Frost, which is the currency they use in Octera. You get that every time you kill a mob, or most times when you kill a mob, anyway. And you get it for doing the events and stuff that you have there. This is an Elden wall-mounted screen or something like this. This comes from Grim Vault. When you get the Grim Vault rep, I think it's a tier 3 Grim Vault rep, and you can buy these. They're probably like, I forgot how much these things cost. They're very, very cheap. Maybe a gold or something like that. Maybe not even quite a gold, but these are insanely cheap. Okay, so that is the bridge and command area. You have your ventilation system here. And the ship is, by the design, made to look very heavy and armored. Going down the hallway here is, if you're going to be on taking troops in the battle, and they're going to have to be aboard the ship for a few days, there's a barracks on the ship. One of the things that I wanted to do is, you'll be able to look up and you'll see pipes and wires and cables and stuff. Hanging down. I'm trying to make it as realistic as possible. Also, you can look down through the floor grates, and you can see down under and through these conduits is where you will have all your pipes and cables and stuff. Here is the barracks over on this side. This is going to be the toilet. Now, I don't know if Grinux actually use the toilet or not. I mean, they're made out of rocks. I don't know if I even want to know what they poop, if they poop at all. But I'm going to put it in a bathroom just in case they're transporting someone else. The barracks is going to be set up like this. You're going to have you're going to have 9 bunks per cubicle. So it'll carry about a platoon's worth of people. I might be able to stick a couple of bunks along here. Like I said, it's going to be tight, but they're only flying in a battle. They're not actually here to enjoy a cruise. It's not a cruise ship. This is the place that we came in right here. This leads to the ground, to the bottom floor in the area where the troops deploy. At the end of this hall is the engine room, and it's far from finished. I've got a lot to do in this engine room, but I just got the basics in place so I can know where everything's going to go. Yeah, you have a control system here. Across from the engine room is sick bay. I've got to go and get a door for it. I haven't had time to do that yet. This one is going to be probably three beds, examination table, the doctor's desk, and over here there'll be the medical monitor. I just haven't purchased that yet either. And in this room is my transporter room, because you know I'm going to build one. If I build a ship, it's going to have a transporter. And it's got the same two, that the only two that's in the game, which is Palavera Point and the initialization core Y-83. Now this ship does have one thing that my other ship didn't have. This time I have, if you go up this ladder in the transporter room, you come to an area that has your tools. It's got ladders. See if I can, you got your toolbox ladders, and you'll have more tools and stuff around here. But you have a door, and guess what? Access to the outside of the ship. I don't have to go jumping around and trying to get on the ship. I can actually just go out the door and access the ship from there. The outside of the ship from there. It's made building this one a whole lot easier than I can be on top of it. It is a missile vessel, so you have you're gonna have missile launchers. Now I'll probably put cannons here, since this is a protected area. Now the idea is, once this ship hits the ground, you can actually have infantry, ranged infantry up here, being able to operate guns and turrets and stuff like that, and they'll be able to support ground troops from here. So I'm going to probably put up some shielding around this where they can actually have some cover. And as you can see, the ship has hard points. Now, not every inch of it is covered in, you know, 2-foot armor plating, but I have hard points on it, so in places where it's most likely to be hit. I try to keep the amount of soft armor kind of like at an angle like this, so you most likely get a glancing blow. But hopefully they'll hit one of the actual hard points and do little or no damage to the ship. But weight is always going to be a consideration. So when you have big armor plates like this, and this of course is protecting the intel station down here, and it's a lot of armor here, because keep in mind a Grinnock is quite a bit larger than a human, and so this is like a Grinnock foot thick, so it's going to be about 2 or 3 feet thick for a human. And it's actually designed to, if their enemy is above them and they're shooting down, the likelihood that they're going to destroy the people in the intel area will be diminished. And the same thing is going to happen here over where the command area is, where you have the people planning the battle and whatnot. This ship has 4 engines, and these are Starship engines. You can get these from doing the the I forgot what those it. You see like a spaceship at certain places, and if you do that quest line, you can get spaceship parts. This is an Osun column, a frostforge column. That I got, it was a drop, and I put a rocket launcher on top of this one because this one can actually shoot at a 360 degree angle without sending a rocket into your engines. Now these backbone or spine here, this is actually a Soul Frost conduit from Octera, from the Soul Frost vendor. And I used two of those to actually make a nice rigid framework for the ship. This one actually does have a skylight in it so people can actually look out. Big armor plates on the side here to protect the infantrymen that's about to go into battle. This is a Soul Frost conduit short. There's a long version of this. This is a short version. Probably should have used a long version here, but I didn't. And you got Soul Frost bust, which were also dropped on that side. And this is a Soul Frost banner, all from Octera. Now, before I'm done, one of the things I'm going to have to do is go in and find a way to seal up all the places that you see that air would be able to get into the ship. Otherwise, it couldn't leave the ground. But I think that's about it. I think that's all I got so far. This is a abandoned Elden layup or something like that, I believe is what it's called. It's actually an instance, but it seemed more like it's got challenges in it. It was pretty fun. I got past the first part, the second part, the jumping challenge. I'm really bad at jumping challenges. I haven't completed that part yet. This one is a Elden excavation. It's also a challenge, and I have not completed that challenge yet. I've tried them, but I've only tried them maybe once, so I haven't actually completed any of those. And as you can see, this one has kind of a different emblem on it, and that's because I didn't get another one of the banners to drop. I got an awesome face to drop, so you know, like I said, I'm building this ship mostly out of drops. I want to see if I can actually make a ship that's not going to cost hundreds of platinum. And because I'm trying to keep the cost down on this, it's probably going to take a little bit longer to build because I am having to wait for drops. Alright, well, I hope you enjoyed the video. That's all I got for right now. I think what I'm going to do, and I've already done Palomar Point today, so I am going to mosey on out to Core Y83, and there I'm going to fight the Corrupted Access Guardian. Okay, that was interesting. Got a 2-belt. I just got a public safety just for coming here. Okay, but this is where that terminal will take you, by the way. And, well, you know, while I got you, let me show you the bot where you get this terminal. When you hit level 50, you go to the defile. You take the transporter from your capital city, and it'll actually drop you right off in the place where you need to be. Lightspire events going on, but I don't know if anybody's doing it this early. I know I certainly am not up for it. I just switched the engineer on this guy, Let's see. I've unlocked scientists on him. Soldier. Scientist is very good because you can summon people and you can make a portal back to your capital city. Settler, of course, for campfires. I'm working on settler now. I'm only at level 3 on settlers. I got soldier up to level 30. I think it was last night. So you can open these for 60. Like if you want to open one, unlock one, it's going to cost you, which I've spent all of my service tokens, so I'm a bit broke. But it costs 60 service tokens, and then you can open a new skill and level that skill up. But anyway, when you get off the transport, which will be here, you just walk right around to this guy, and he's going to have a
free
quest.
Will is a gift. Enjoy it.
What is it? I can't remember the name of the robot. You got to go find some robot's parts. And then when you finish doing that, you'll get the fight the corrupted Access Guardian.
Your efforts
and then
are appreciated,
after that,
sentient.
You'll go back to that tower that I just came in on, and you'll see the you'll get the terminal that you can go and put back at your place, and be able to do that quest. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you have any comments, please feel free. All I ever ask is that you keep it mature and civil. And if you have any questions, let me know. I will do my best to answer them. I've got a lot of stuff, so most... Oh, somebody's going to do this one, huh? I don't think I feel up to it today. I got a lot of stuff in the game, so if you have any questions about where something come from, I can generally tell you. There are some things I don't know, like the gas giant. I'd love to get my hands on one, but I have no idea where they drop. I got a sneaky suspicion it drops the same as the spaceship engines and stuff, but I'm not very sure about that. Anyway, guys, you have a great day.